my life. It made me start thinking that perhaps with all the privileges I've actually had, as opposed to being a victim of something, that I've had a lot of privileges to get to where I was, that I should give back, I should do something for other people. I think if you look at the strand that weaves through all of GEP's programs, it's about young people having power, about young people being able to pursue careers and interests that they create and they decide.
The dream that we are giving, so generally that will be the nature.
The Entrepreneurship and Employment Training Program is mostly for 7th and 8th grade up through to high school and then unemployed youth up to age 24, 25, where they then learn career skills like how to start and run a business or how to find a job.
Grace is a hairdresser. This is a new concept in GEP. She went through our EETP classes where she learned some basic entrepreneurship skills. GEP provided her with a grant because we thought it's an idea that was very viable.
Hey, Grace.
Oh, hi.
Hello, Mzuri. Mambo.
Ah,
this is Anthony. Mm-hmm. Anthony is an EETP graduate.
So how long have you been doing this?
I started by grinding coffee and sell it to the locals. They funded me and I bought a few things. I had dryers. And then that's how I started. I only had one staff at that time. Instead of sitting around, you can create your own job and start doing something for yourself, and you employ others who cannot afford to earn a daily bread. And, well, I enjoy it a lot. I'm a boss. If this business reaches where I want to sponsor a few youths so that they can also go to GEP. Get what I got and reach where I've reached.
Tony has been an inspiring model. He works very hard, and what he did to make Global what it is today, it's something that I cannot forget. That's why I believe, in fact, I was motivated to join Global because of its mission, helping the communities and the youth to become employable and self-reliant. As the director of Kenya Division, I also feel challenged that what Tony is doing, I can also do it. So I'm also working very hard to get in-country funds for our division here.
Habari zenu. Mwasinda mana? Moko mana? Haya.
The community was very, very supportive. They decided to give Tony a Taita name, which is Mwakazi. Mwakazi in Taita means a hard-working person.
A very good working relationship with your office.
You will hear everybody shouting, Mwakazi, Mwakazi, Mwakazi.
Eh, mzuri sana.
How are you, Bwana Mwakazi? How have you been?
The family is doing well anyway.
People love seeing Tony. Everybody would want to greet him because they see Tony as somebody who has helped change the people, the communities, and the youth.
It does mean a lot to me that people here in Taita call me Mwakazi. Chief Mwasingo gave it to me. We're at a ceremony and he said, Bwana Tony, you know, you've worked hard for the community. He's like, you know, we should call you Mwakazi. People here accepted me as one of their own and enough to give me one of their names. One time I was in Voi, which is about 40 miles from Wundanyi, and I was waiting for a train to Nairobi, and this little child, about 9 years old, came up to me and said, Wewe ni Mwakazi? You know, are you Mwakazi? And that really was just this wonderful feeling for me. It's like, I don't know, I mean, I can walk around in Washington, D.C. for hours and not see anyone I know.
Hey, buddy,
things. But here, I don't know, I feel like people know me, I feel like a part of the community, and I feel accepted.
GEP is in Tanzania because this is the third poorest country in the world. There's a tremendous amount of poverty. It's mostly subsistence farming. Global Education Partnership's mission is to increase the employability and self-reliance of youth. What's going on here is these students are participating in a one-day business workshop and learning by doing. It's the first step toward learning how to start a business for the young people that attend this program. They go out and start a business for the day, and they come up with their idea based on their own interests and what they perceive to be the demand in the community, and they run with it. We're in Lushoto Market. This is, as you can see, is the center of commerce for Lushoto. You have various people here selling their wares, everything from vegetables to clothing, pretty much you name it, it's being sold here. We have a lot of our students, as a part of the one-day business workshop, are here selling their wares. A lot of the students are very shy, and once they go out there, they realize, wow, okay, that wasn't so hard. Okay. You know, maybe they get a few rejections, but they also make some sales. Now this is Marion. You're your partner, right?
Yes.
You guys started your business together. And that's empowering for them. Now after that, the students go out and actually design a business plan for a real business that they want to start, not just for a day, but potentially for years.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
So that's another good reason to start a business here in Lushoto. Once they achieve a certain level of success, they're able to also not just create jobs for themselves, but also for others. What that does is it creates industry in a rural community where there isn't much industry. One thing beyond that that's very, very important to us is that they find something they really love to do. You know, if you love what you're doing, it doesn't feel like work, and you enjoy it, and your livelihood just becomes a part of your life, and you're happy. That's what we're hoping for these youth.
My program is trying to keep them in track, to see that they are using the skill which they have obtained in class, and to see that they are continuing with the business. I have to visit every student. I usually go to the student business sites and see what are they doing and advise them on how to keep good records. Habari yako njao? Habari za leo?
Wateja wanifuate badala mimi kufuata tena. Tumia katika matumizi mengine ya kawaida.
Kama nini?
Kama vile kujikupali kupangisha. Kuongesha chumba, malazi, kununua vitu vyangu vya kawaida, nguo, na kusaidia wazazi.
I like to see students working the field, doing the business. If they need help from me, I can give them anytime, anywhere.
Habari yako?
Nzuri, habari gani?
Nzuri, habari za hapa?
Nzuri. Ndiyo, mimi ninaweza kufanya.
The Flora was the first graduate of Entrepreneurship and Employment Training Program. She is a secretary and bookkeeper in the Agricultural Training College.
Nimekuwa na hamu ya kujifunza kompyuta kwanza kwa sababu tuko kwenye hali ya mabadiliko. Watu inabidi kama kwenye position yangu mimi kama secretary nijue kompyuta. Kwa hiyo hii ilikuwa ni haja ya kwanza na pili tulikuwa nayo tayari kompyuta hapa.
Hili ni faili la barua zilizofika hivi karibuni.
Flora, she's more valuable to our institute after she has taken her course. With computer, she can type examinations for our students here, as well as official letters.
Maisha ninayoona baada ya GEP ni mazuri kwa sababu pia ninaweza hata fanya kazi sehemu yoyote ile kwa sababu sehemu nyingi sasa wanatumia kompyuta. Kwa hiyo na mimi naweza kutafuta kazi eneo lingine kwa ajili ya ujuzi ule niliopata.
Baada kidogo.